We shall fight on the seas and oceans. We shall fight with growing confidence and growing strength in the air.
Hi guys, welcome back to the channel. And we've got another update for you from Warlord. This time it's on the new rules for snipers. Now, before we go into the new rules for snipers, let's have a quick look at the old rules. So, quickly put it on the screen. Oh, here we are. So these are the old rules for snipers in version 2, and I've included the rule for exceptional damage because the old rules for snipers used to cause exceptional damage, which no longer exists anymore. Anyway, so we have a quick look through. So snipers claim, so I'll have a quick look through and I'll quickly read what it says. So a sniper team includes a marksman with a high power telescopic sight, and also includes an observer or loader, and they have a rifle range is 36 inches. However, within 12 inches, you can't use the sniper rule, and a shot will miss automatically. The shot ignores negative hit modifiers, except for pinning, and for the missing assistant, if the sniper is the last man standing. And so when you were shooting with the sniper, your only negative to hit modifier was for pinning. So if you had the pin, then it'd be plus one to hit. Or if you lost your assistant, then again, you'd be plus one to hit. But otherwise, ignore terrain, ignore the small teams rule, ignore all them. So it made snipers good. I'm saying good because I never have used it with them and I never took them. I thought the 50 points or so that you spent on a sniper was better spent elsewhere. But it may be different for version 3, if you follow me along. So the sniper, a successful roll to hit and damage always counts as exceptional damage, hence why I've included the exceptional damage rule. Firing player can pick any model in the target unit as a casualty. And like other units with the team special rules, all members of the sniper team can fire any weapon they are carrying in any turn when a sniper is not using his scope. So in version 2, he had a sniper team. If he was using his sniper rifle, then he would fire one shot with the sniper rifle at whatever target he was using. However, you could use the rifles, or if you had SMGs, you could use them. So you could have a two-man team running around firing four shots with SMGs. It's funny it says that, because I'm not actually sure in the rules you can actually give your sniper team other weapons. I thought they had to have rifles, but that's what it said anyway. So anyway, let's go on to the exceptional damage rule. So if you hit, it's classed as exceptional damage. So what exactly is exceptional damage? So the shooter picks which model falls casualty rather than his opponent, which was a big one. This represents the fact that sometimes a Sarge will get hit or machine gun jam or be jammed beyond repair. So basically in version 2, if you manage to hit with a sniper and you cause a wound, it's exceptional damage. You can pick the gunner on a medium machine gun team and the whole medium machine gun was gone. And that was one of the big drawbacks with medium machine guns and why a lot of people didn't take them. Apart from they didn't really have a lot of firepower, and for the cost of a medium machine gun, which was about 50 points. So if you took a 50 point medium machine gun, 50 points, five shots, and unless you were German, you got an extra shot, but it's five shots roughly, and you were fixed, so you had to shoot in your front arc. Whereas you could take a five man infantry squad with an LMG, which would be 70 points. You had an LMG and four rifles, which could shoot in any direction, So I never took MMG because I always thought a five-man squad with LMG was more bang for your points. So that's the old version 2 sniper rules. Now let's have a look at the new version 3. So what they said on the website was, because the removal of exceptional damage special rules and the introduction of cover saves as part of the old excitement, they're saying that snipers would no longer be the absolute weapon team deleting killing machines that had been in second edition. Now, I never found them to be anyway, because when I roll, I would lucky if I get one hit with a sniper rifle all game. I didn't have much luck with snipers. And if you go through the battle reports that I've got on the channel, you find I don't think I've played with a sniper in at least 2 or 3 years. Certainly, probably pre-COVID, last time I used a sniper on the table. I just didn't think they were worth it. Flamethrower team, bazooka team, that was about it. I just mainly ran infantry squads. So, although they're saying they were the absolute weapon team deleting killing machines, I never ever found them to be that. But that's why they've made these changes, or that's one of the reasons why they give. So, not to say, however, that it's all bad news for snipers. They're an iconic part of World War II combat. After all, with one hand, take away with one hand, give us new abilities. So we're going to have a look at the new sniper special rule. So here it is. This is the new sniper version 3 rules. And there's a few changes, but there's quite a bit that still stays the same. So the leader of the unit is equipped with a high-powered telescopic sight, same as in version 2. The unit officer includes a second man, as in second edition. And the sniper has a team special rule, which means that if the leader is killed, the second man can fire his sniper rifle with the usual minus one penalty to hit, as well as the minus one penalty to morale due to the loss of the leader. Unlike other units with a team weapon special rule, all members of a sniper team can fire any weapon they are carrying in any turn when the sniper is not using the scope. So that's still the same as well. So if you've got other weapons, if you choose not to fire your sniper rifle, you can fire the weapons that both guys got. So if you've got a sniper team and they both got rifles, you can either fire one shot with your sniper rifle, or you can forego that and fire two shots both of the rifles in the team. So that's still the same. So when a sniper shoots using the fire or ambush order, clearly decide the sniper used the rifle scope, in which case the following special rules apply. So these are the new rules for snipers. So the range changes to 36, however the target is then found to be within 12 inches, the shot misses automatically. That's the same as version 2. The shot benefits from additional plus one modifier to hit. Now, that brings it back in line with version 2 again, because in version 3, pretty much everything's now a 4 plus to hit. So with an additional plus one to hit, it means that the version 3 sniper is still hitting on a 3 plus. And then it says any hits go straight to damage, no cover saves allowed. So there's no cover saves. So that's another biggie. And benefit from a plus one modifier to damage on the roll against infantry and artillery. So basically, when a sniper is shooting at infantry or artillery, the AP1, when shooting at tanks, no difference, but if you're shooting at infantry, they get plus one. So if you're shooting at a veteran unit and you hit them, you then only need 4 to kill, not 5, because you get plus 1 to damage. So that's actually a big increase. And then if the sniper successfully hits and damages the firing player, can pick the squad leader in the target unit as your casualty. This includes NCOs, leaders of weapons teams and artillery units, officers, medics, observers and so on. Now it says can pick the squad leader as a casualty. It doesn't mention you can take out flamethrower teams or special weapons, etc. So that's interesting. I don't know if it'll clarify that later on. So next up, let's see what they say next. So a quick recap. This is what they put on for their recap. So what stays the same. So the 12 to 36 inch range is the same. You can use either the sniper rifle or other weapons the team might be carrying. And that's about it, really. Starting from the top, the changes we've added, actually got quite a durable weapon system. If you kill the sniper and the survivor pass a morale check, taking 50% casualties, the loader picks up the rifle and can still perform the role, albeit with some negatives. Now that's another thing as well, because the small weapons seem to have gone. If you've got a two-man team and you lose one man from that team, you're doing a morale check to see whether they stay on the table. That's one thing you have to remember. So the other thing is the completely ignore cover and plus 1 to hit if using a special ability. I mentioned that instead of 4s to hit, they're on 3s to hit. And it says the makes them ideal for dealing with units that are dug in, especially small teams like bazooka teams, anti-tank, or just sniper teams, etc. Any small two-man teams, really, they're ideal to hit because, as I say, if you take out one of them, you're automatically forcing a morale check because you're down to one guy. And you can also use this to target officers as well. If there's only a two-man officer team, you might be able to take out the officer. Although they do get the morale boost, but there's always the option there. You can try and take out their officer and force a check and maybe lose the whole team, which is all the dice out the bag. And then last up, we've got this, where he's talking about the damage. So the plus 1 modifier against infantry and archery means that you hit as far more likely to remove models. This is a huge bonus when dealing with veterans and makes regulars and experienced troops an absolute double. And then finally we come to the fact that sniper scores a hit and damage while using their ability. You get to pick the team leader as the casualty. Yes, you read that right. Not the guy with the Panzerfaust, not the machine gunner, or the bloke in the fancy hat yelling orders. Now, if you're shooting at a standalone weapons team, for example, another sniper team, then the team leader is usually the man with the special weapon. His comrade will pick up his kit and keep firing, appears at a reduced efficiency once again. For two-man teams, that's if the survivor passes his morale check. So that basically what it means is if you're shooting at a team, because the exceptional damage is gone, you will shoot at a two-man team, you kill one of the guys, and the main weapon will stay there. We'll just go to minus 1. That's reworded, but that was the same in version 2 anyway. So it says this allows snipers to feel historically more appropriate without being either too weak or too powerful on the tabletop. By and large, sniper doctrine is always focused on shoot and shouty ones. Shoot the shouty ones first, throwing the enemy into disarray by eliminating leaders. That's fine. Now, have a quick. Let's do a quick comparison between a V2 and V3. So let's throw back up the version 2 rules again for snipers. So if you were shooting in version 2, you would be shooting at a target, and your only negative modifiers you have are any pins you've got, or you're missing the assistant. So if you've not got any issues and you're hitting on threes, shooting because you ignore terrain and everything, as long as you can see your target, like they're not behind the building, they've not got line of sight, you can't shoot at them. But if you can see the target and it's in range, you can shoot them. Threes hit, you then have to roll against their training level, so you need a 4 up for a regular or a 5 up for a veteran. So you could hit them, but then you need a 5 or so to kill them. Now in V3, shooting is 4 up. So what they've done is they give snipers a bonus to shooting, so they get +1 to shooting, so they're hitting on a 3 up like they did in V2. So again, they ignore cover. So you aim your sniper rifle, boom, again, if the target's in range and shooting, then you can shoot them. You ignore cover, there's no small teams, none of that to worry about. But they get +1 damage. So we're in version 2, you need 3+ to hit, and you're shooting at a veteran, you then need a 5 to kill that veteran, or to kill a veteran. Now in V3, you need a 4 up, but you get +1 because you're a sniper rule, so you need a 3 up to hit them. And then if they're a veteran, you get +1 damage because it's infantry, so you then need a 4 up to kill them. So your sniper has become more effective against infantry. Although they've took out the ability to instant kill a unit, kill probably the same number of miniatures, but from different things. But if you can delete the NCOs, the HQs from squads, you're going to be putting them on permanent -1 to the morale, which is a big deal. So if you can hit with your sniper, your sniper becomes more effective, you're going to do a lot more damage to the morale, which is a big thing in bolt action, as everyone knows, than you did in V2, than you ever did in V2. So I think the new sniper rules are actually good. A lot of people don't like them, but I think it's going to improve the way snipers work. Yes, they cannot delete a team, but if they're shooting at a small two-man team, they can force a morale check and maybe delete a team that way, because they're going to find, especially if it's a veteran or a regular, because they're going to do damage, they're going to kill, they're going to cause a casualty on that team easier than they did in version 2. Because in version 2, if there was a veteran bazooka team there, you needed a 3 up to hit and then a 5 up to kill one of them. And if you managed to get the 5 up, then you'd eliminate the team. Now in version 3, you still need a 3 up to hit, but you don't need a 5 up to kill this time. You need a 4 up because you've got your +1 damage. And then you'll kill one of the guys, and then you force a morale check, and the team could go anyway like it did in version 2. So I actually think against smaller teams, the sniper is going to be more effective in version 3 than they were in version 2. The larger teams, 3-4 man teams, like mortar teams, etc., and the artillery, they're not going to be as effective, because obviously you can't delete the mortar team from one shot on them, because that ability is gone. But you can still put the pins on them. So that's my thoughts on the new version 3 sniper rules. I do like them. I say there's a lot of people out there think, not keen on this. I don't know how many points a sniper is going to be in version 3. They might be less than they are now. I don't know. If they are less, that's again. But I will try snipers. As I say, I've not really played them in version 2. Because I didn't have any luck with them. Probably because I used to play against Jim and Falschenjäger, who were mainly all veterans. So I could maybe hit them with 3+, but then I needed 5s to damage. And I didn't roll that many 5s. So, and you only 1 shot per turn. So the whole game is 6 shots. And you can hit them, but taking them out, I mean, I'm lucky if I get one kill, one guy killed in a game with a sniper. So I never took them in version 2. I will try them in version 3 and see if they perform better. But that's for another time, when things are up and running and we get to play. Thanks for watching, and join me all next time when we continue our look into the new version 3 ball sucking rules. Thanks very much for watching. Don't forget to hit the like and subscribe. See you all next time.
We shall fight on the beaches. We shall fight on the landing grounds. We shall fight in the fields and in the streets. We shall fight in the hills. We shall never surrender. And if, which I do not for a moment believe, this island or a large part of it was subjugated and starving, then our empire beyond the seas, armed and guarded by the British fleet,